Where's your cereal bowl?
I'm not hungry.
You need to eat something.
I'm not hungry.
You need to have something before you go to school. Okay,
do you want some jelly on it?
Yes, please.
Okay. Watch it, Brenda. Don't mess my clothes up. Billy Baker's in my math class this year.
Oh, did he flunk too?
Shut up.
Hey.
You're one to talk.
Are you excited about your first day of school?
Yeah.
Isn't your sister?
Ew, you stink.
Very cute.
Mom, he stinks. We have a rule. He's got to shower before he eats with us.
Maybell, honey, here's your juice.
Thanks.
Okay, who hid my sneakers?
Jess, you could hardly call them sneakers anymore. I threw them out.
What? Mom!
I'm sorry, but I will not send any child of mine to school looking like some hobo. There's a perfectly good old pair of Brenda's that I put out for you.
These are girls' ones.
It's a fan belt this time, but I got another.
Ellie, honey, here you go.
What's the matter with you?
There's a big race today.
And?
My sneakers.
I've got a perfectly good pair for him to use.
Yeah, these are girls' ones. I can't race in these.
You couldn't race in your old ones either.
You need some new sneakers, Mary.
We don't have anything left for us to
use
right now.
They make them the same. You got your chores done?
Just about to.
It was way in back.
Trying to keep my pit stops under 10 seconds, Ace.
Give it.
Give it. Hey, that's my line. Yeah,
I found it.
Are you kidding?
Okay, that's enough.
Consider it a free lunch program, farmer boy.
All right, settle down.
Good one, Janice.
What do you call your teacher again? I want to tell Alexandra.
Monster Mouth, now scoot.
Alexandra, they call her Monster Mouth Myers.
I said scoot.
A few ground rules for this classroom. No talking, no chewing gum, no electronic devices. Be forewarned. If you download any essay off of the internet, you will be downloaded into detention. So, let's start the year off on the right foot and all do our own work. I expect you to take notes.
Beep, 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 beep. Know what that is? My loser detector. Beep, beep, beep.
Jesse Aarons. I got it from your sisters. I certainly do not need it from you. Oh, that goes for you as well.
He hit me. You did me.
Scott Hoger and Gary Fulcher, be quiet. Now, back to what we were discussing before we were so rudely interrupted.
Sweet sneaks, Aarons. You wear your sister's hand-me-down underwear, too?
He asked you a question, Twinkle Toes.
Good morning, kids. Welcome back. I hope you had a great summer. Mrs. Myers, this is Leslie Burke, who will be joining your class. Leslie, welcome to Lark Creek.
Thanks.
Thank you, Principal Turner. Oh, Leslie, you'll just have to sit at my desk this morning until we figure out where to squeeze you in. I like to start out the year with a little fun. I want you all to write a one-page essay about your favorite hobby. Yes.
Mrs. Myers, when you say one page, did you mean both sides of the paper?
You can just do one side, Madison.
I'll do two.
You can have, like, $2 after all, but hey, I'm doing this, okay?
Excuse
me? Got a dollar?
No.
Then you're gonna have to use your pants.
What's your problem?
You got that backwards, freak. You got the problem. That's right, new girl.
Nice feet.
You say something?
What I said was, have you ever heard the story about the trolls under the bridges who collect tolls from unlucky travelers?
Trolls? What is she talking about? Nice try, Beanpole.
It's still a dollar.
Let's do this thing. Come on. Poacher, Hoger, get in here. Get ready. Come on, let's get this race started. Come on.
Beep, 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 beep.
Back behind the line. You know how it goes. Back behind. Come on.
Hey, new girl. This is just for guys. Hey, I'm talking to you.
What's the matter, Hoger? Afraid a girl's gonna beat you?
On your mark. Get set.
Get me.
Go!
Seconds, Ace.
Thank you.
Are you following me?
No. I live over there.
We're neighbors? He got little sisters?
No. Just me.
Oh. You got any Barbies?
Yeah. I think I have a few. You got any?
Yeah. I have one. And a half.
And a half.
One got killed in half playing Super Extreme Barbies.
Never heard of that before.
You flush the toilet with them in it. You drop them from the upstairs window. Stuff like that. It's really fun.
Sounds like fun. Well, I'll see you around.
Yeah. See ya.
See ya.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Dad.
Hey, I'm just going to get some supplies. You want to come?
Yeah, sure.
See ya.
Yeah, there we go. This one.
She spilled it. How come it's my fault?
When I ask you to watch the baby, I mean watch the baby, Brenda.
It's Ellie's turn.
Mm-hmm. I'm doing my algebra.
Put a little more cream on there.
Hey!
The girls are gonna have to start helping out a lot more around here. You're not little kids anymore.
Maybelle, how many times have I told you, stay out of my stuff?
It wasn't me.
It was to you.
Can't prove it.
Your mom, here, you too.
Daddy.
Sweetie, is he picking on you?
She was in my stuff.
What stuff? How'd that race go?
There's this new girl moved in next door. She beat all of the boys, even Jess.
Make sure you take out the garbage before supper. One drop. And that's the magic. Here comes Maybelle's flowers.
Are these ever gonna grow?
This greenhouse is gonna be filled with your purple flowers. Maybelle's flowers.
I know this is the one that had, like, purple all over it. They are so cool.
I think these things are gonna grow fast.
Me too.
Bet you come out here tomorrow, it's gonna be filled with them.
Yeah.
Good morning, everybody!
Good morning, Evans!
Aren't you glad that summer's over?
No!
No? I am. Come and get your instruments.
Can I do a woodblock?
Take a picture. Last longer.
Awfully quiet. Old MacDonald had a farm. No! You don't like that song?
No!
Then make some noise! Come on!
Maybe you can pick up another shift at the store.
Give me.
Wow. You're really good at drawing. Like, better than any kid I've ever seen.
Oh, thanks.
I want to share this composition for two reasons. One, it uses adjectives well. And two, it's clear the author paid attention to what she saw and what she was feeling, which is important for any writing. Self-contained underwater breathing apparatus by Leslie Burke. Leslie, why don't you read it for us?
I'm moving gently forward over the wild and beautiful unexplored world below me. I'm floating in silence and breaking it up with the sound of my breath. Above me, there's nothing but shimmery light, the place where I have come from and will go back to when I am done here. I am diving. I'm a scuba diver. I'm going deeper past the wrinkled rocks and dark seaweed. A deep blueness where a school of silverfish wait. As I swim through the water, bubbles burst from me, wobbling like little jellyfish as they rise. I check my air. I don't have as much time as I need to see everything, but that is what makes it so special.
Thank you, Leslie. Now, tonight at 7 on Channel 4, there is a special about an undersea explorer, Dr. Bob Ballard. I want everyone to watch and write one page about what you've learned. Leslie.
What if you can't watch this program?
If you inform your parents it's an assignment, I'm sure they won't object.
But what if you don't have a TV? My dad says the TV kills your brain cells.
Your dad doesn't know anything. We watch TV, like, every day.
I rest my case.
Well then, Leslie, you don't have to write this essay. You can pick something else to write about.
Yeah, like how to live in a cave.
Well, that's enough, Mr. Hoger.
Hey, Leslie, what are you going to write your essay?
Yeah. That's in the cave?
Janice is seen.
She thinks she's doing.
Chess, the big kids will kill us.
out whether you're asked for it or not. So might as well have some fun.
Getting Janice all wound up is a weird way of having fun.
Well, what's your idea of having fun?
I don't know.
Well, you want to do something?
I don't know.
Let's do something. Definitely. What should we do?
You can't do it.
Do what?
What we're doing.
Hey, Maybelle. I don't use my Barbies so much anymore. If you want, you can have them.
To keep for permanent?
Sure.
Thanks.
You're lucky to have a sister.
Yeah, I got four of them, and I trade them all for a good dog.
I'd love to have a dog.
Now let's go before she changes her mind.
Race to the end of the road. On your mark, set, go!
Sharks. You ever see any sharks while you're scubaing or whatever?
I've never gone scuba diving my whole life.
You lied in your essay?
No, I made it up. It's different from lying. Those drawings you made. You really seen all those things yourself?
No, but...
Hey, look at that.
Cool.
That's been there forever. I wouldn't trust it.
Come on, just try it. You got it?
What are you doing?
Getting up higher. Much fun. You have to try it. Come on. Watch the clouds. Feels like flying. There's no Janice Avery's or Scott Hookers.
Yeah, but when we go back to school, there they are waiting.
Yeah, but someplace better than just not being at school. What if there was a magical kingdom that only we knew about?
I don't know. What if?
Okay, well, what if the only way we could enter it is by swinging on this enchanted rope?
Enchanted rope?
Yeah. Come on.
Leslie! Leslie!
Wait up. Our land.
Not so loud. They'll hear you.
What are you talking about?
Hey, what's that? Whoa, Jess, look at this. Wow. Too bad for them. They got so close.
What are you talking about?
To the kingdom.
What's that?
What?
That sound, I've heard it before. Someone's out there.
That's the sound of the prisoners rattling their chains.
What prisoners?
The prisoners of the Dark Master.
We should go.
Wait! Jess, look!
What is it?
Try dragonflies.
No, they're warriors. From the treetop provinces.
I don't know this game.
What game? This is for real. This is the ruins of the once great fortress, whose people have been imprisoned. Jess, you and I have been sent to free them.
Prisoners of the Dark Master! Hear me! We have come to free you! Do you hear us? Show me that you hear us!
You just got lucky timing. The wind's been blowing off and on all day.
Don't you think we should give her a hand?
She's fine.
Beep, 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 beep.
There are four of us. Okay. Meet me at the end of our journey.
Remember to bring your bike.
So
problem.
Jess Ahrens tripped me. On purpose.
Okay, Ahrens. Hit the road.
But he didn't do anything.
Go.
It was definitely Ahrens.
I know. Thank you.
Good job, Jess.
What happened to you?
Janice Avery is a very talented person. She can shoot ketchup packets over four rows of seats.
Jeez.
Can I wash up at your house? My mom sees this and she'll be all over the principal and everybody, and my life will be over.
Oh, hello.
Mom, this is Leslie.
Hi, Leslie.
Hi.
It's nice to meet you.
Thank you. You too.
So, are you and your family getting settled in okay?
Yes, ma'am.
That's nice.
See you later.
Not too late, okay, honey?
Weird and weirder.
Hey, be glad he's found a friend.
Where's your dad work?
At home. Same as my mom. They're writers.
Writers? What do they write about?
Fiction.
That explains you.
What do you mean?
Well, you like to make things up, and that's what your parents do for a living.
You know a lot about hardware?
No. Why?
Well, your dad works at a hardware store.
Okay.
All I'm saying is that you are who you are, not your parents.
Well, if they work at your house, you must get to hang out with them a lot.
Not really. What's that?
Grenade.
There are no grenades here.
Come on. Squirrels.
Part squirrel, part Scott Hoger.
Squoger.
Scroger. Sneaky foot soldiers of the Dark Mask. They're attacking.
We need ammo.
Not good. See him up there?
Yeah.
Do you? Really?
Yeah.
Beep, 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 beep.
Leslie?
Kingdom from up here. Isn't this cool? We can do anything here. Look at it. It's all ours. From the mountains to the oceans.
What am I looking for exactly?
You'll see. Just close your eyes, but keep your mind wide open.
Wow. What do we call this place?
Terabithia.
Shh. Everybody tiptoe. Okay.
Ready? Happy birthday!
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Make a wish. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
What'd you wish for?
It's cheap junk.
No, it isn't. I love it.
How can you love something that doesn't even work?
I don't think we have the hang of it yet, Dad.
You know what? Keep the box and we'll see if we can take it back.
Daddy, there's something in the greenhouse.
It's the last thing I need. Some animal chewing its way in here.
What are you gonna do if you catch it?
Well, these vegetables are part of our livelihood. We can't afford to share them with any animal we get in here.
So you're gonna kill it?
Have to.
Well, he's not gonna get in here now. Right, Dad?
Hope not. But if he does, you just let me deal with it.
Is anything else I can help you with?
No, why don't you go on and do your homework? I'll clean this mess up.
Cheaper one if you want.
Thanks. A lot.
Jess and Leslie sitting in the
Look, the squoger and the vulture.
Hey, here he comes.
And a guy who can stand up to a squoger is scared of a hoger?
Miss Edmonds?
He speaks.
Can I help you with those?
You sure can. And you just made my day.
Hey, what's up with you guys?
Great.
Oh, I'll get that one.
Thank you.
Hey, guys.
Oh, hi, boys.
You're so good at that.
Good at what?
Building stuff. I mean, you're really good at it for a girl.
Same way I'm fast. For a girl.
You know what I mean.
You're pretty good at art. For a boy.
Okay, okay, truce. Don't your parents ever notice any of the stuff's missing?
Not when they're in the middle of writing a book.
No, it's a giant tree that almost killed us.
You think that tree just fell all by itself? Come on.
When the Dark Master saw that the squoggers weren't scaring us away, he sent a giant troll.
Uh-oh, how big?
Whoa. That's how big its feet are.
You really think so?
What else could it be?
What should we do?
If we had a troll hunter, we could track its scent, sneak up on it.
Hey, look at that!
Come on!
I think it went that way.
We rule Terabithia, and nothing crushes us!
I'll brace it to the rope.
get out of here and don't come back.
What do you think you're doing?
I took care of it for you.
Did you now? Now, how'd you do that?
I took him way into the forest. He's not coming back now, Dad, I promise.
What, did he tell you he's going to stay the hell out of the greenhouse?
No, just trust me. He went out there. He's not coming.
Jess, you need to understand something, okay? This is not one of your cartoons or whatever. This is just a pest that eats up our food, money we earn, and time we don't have.
Okay.
Now get your head out of the clouds and do as I say. Lights out, Jess.
Night, Dad.
You slaying the giant troll after school today?
You've got your head in the clouds, Leslie.
Huh?
There is no giant troll, right?
Well, you better not let the Terabithians hear you. They thought you were their king.
I should have bought those Twinkies if I were you.
You're just mad because I got some and you didn't.
Whatever. Just don't come crying to me when you lose them.
I'm gonna eat them, not lose them. Jess! Janice Avery stole my Twinkies!
What'd I tell you, Maybelle? You should have kept your mouth shut.
She's over there. What are you gonna do about it?
She makes you pay to pee.
I got it. $2, shorty.
That's not fair, is it? Ping's definitely supposed to be free.
Free the pee! 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 Free the pee!
I want my Twinkies, Janice Avery.
What Twinkies, Twinkie?
You're supposed to beat her up. You're my brother.
Well, do you know what happened if I were to pick a fight with her?
You'll get your butt kicked.
No, I'll get kicked out of school for fighting a girl. What's that gonna prove?
She stole my Twinkies.
Come on.
It's all right, Maybelle. We'll get her back. Won't we, Jess? Don't let the Terabithians hear you. They thought you were their king.
Is your very own certified purebred giant troll hunter.
Oh, he's for me?
Yeah, and he just took a giant pee all over my sweatshirt.
Wow, Jess. Thank you. I name you Prince Tarion, giant troll hunter extraordinaire. PT for short. Hey, I think he smells a troll. Come on.
Oh no, we got company.
What's its weak spot?
Does this thing even have a weak spot?
I don't know.
Just making it matter.
PT!
That's it! That's its weak spot. It's ticklish. Gross!
Full toe jam.
Good boy, PT. Good boy.
What's Janice's weak spot, you think?
Eighth grade girl. Probably eighth grade boys. Who's she got a crush on?
I don't know.
Let's see. Coolest boy in eighth grade is probably Willard Hughes. That's it!
What's it?
Right. Dear Janice.
You do it.
No, wait. Boy's handwriting sucks. No offense. It's gotta be you. Okay. Dear Janice, you're the most amazing and beautiful person I've ever known.
How do I know which desk is hers?
It's the one with dried up blood and dusty old bones.
I do not know if you know this about me, but I need to tell you. I think you are so cool.
You are the coolest over all the other girls in our school.
Okay, write this.
Let's find out if what I think we have is real. Oh, Mr. Bailey.
Huh?
I was looking for you.
Me? Why?
I think someone threw up in the girls' room.
All right, I'll take a look.
Meet me by the bus after school today. We can ride home together and talk about us. Underline and capitalize the S. All my love, Willard.
You know if we get caught, they're both gonna kill us.
Break your leg.
Willard Hughes is gonna ride Janice home today.
What are you talking about?
Willard and Janice. They're totally in love.
Your dream.
Hey.
Well, you better tell Willard that. Because it looks like he's heading home in his own bus. What happened? Didn't Willard know he's totally in love with you?
What just happened?
He just walked away.
I don't like this.
Yes. You wanna go? Can't.
It's a free country!
Don't you dare follow us, or I'll tell Alexandra that you still suck your thumb and sleep with Mr. Blanky. So what'd he say?
They must have finished their book.
How do you know?
Hey, Leslie! We need your help!
Come on! Hey, Mom!
Hey, Leslie, come on!
All right, let's go. We're on a mission.
Hey, this is my friend Jess. Can he help?
So you're the infamous Jess. Hi, I'm Judy. Leslie tells me you're good with a paintbrush. Why don't you grab one and get going? Come on. I am determined to have this wall finished, so when the late sun hits it, we can watch it catch fire.
Now that's one steady hand, Jess. That's an artist's hand. Am I right?
Yeah.
You know, the best prize that life offers is the chance to work hard at work worth doing. That's Teddy Roosevelt said that, not me.
What did I tell you? Was it worth it? Jess, get started on your homework, okay?
I'm gonna be managing the store on weekends starting in a couple of weeks, so I'm gonna need you to pick up on some chores around here.
You know, the best prize that life can offer is working hard at work worth doing.
Classes?
No, I just made them up myself.
You're really talented. Jess, don't let those other kids get in your way.
Oh, here you go.
Thank you.
I just went to use the girls' room. Someone's in one of the stalls crying their eyes out, and I think it's Janice Avery.
But it can't still be that trick you played on her, can it?
No way. But come here.
See the bee!
Get out of here! Get out of here now!
You should go talk to her.
You kidding?
That's not like a skinny knee crying. That's like crying about something serious. Besides, the girl's bathroom. I can't go in there.
Well, I don't want to go in there alone.
What's the matter? A girl who can stand up to a giant troll is afraid of some dumb eighth grader.
Dad gets really mad at her.
So? My dad gets mad at me. Pretty much all the time.
He hits her.
Oh.
And some neighbor heard them yelling so loud that they called the police. And it got out. And all the 7th and the 8th graders know about it.
Whoa.
Which explains, like, a lot.
Well, what did you say to her?
Well, I told her about not having a TV, and everyone laughing at me. and that I know what it's like to have everyone think I was weird.
Then what'd she say?
She asked me for advice.
Janice Avery asked you for advice?
Yeah.
And?
Well, I told her just to pretend that she had no idea what anyone was talking about. And in a few weeks' time, everybody would just forget about it.
Man.
Then I gave her a piece of gum.
We should go.
Yeah. Wanna come back tomorrow?
I can't, I got chores.
How about the next day?
Sunday, we go to church.
Can I come?
You'd hate it.
No, I think it'd be cool.
Girls can't wear pants.
I've got dresses, Jess.
You in a dress? That'd be a sight. See ya.
Terabithia. I'm really glad I came. That whole Jesus thing, it's really interesting, isn't it?
It's not interesting. It's scary. It's nailing holes through your hands. It's because we're all vile sinners. God made Jesus die.
You really think that's true?
It's in the Bible, Leslie.
You have to believe it, and you hate it. I don't have to believe it, and I think it's beautiful.
You gotta believe the Bible, Leslie.
Why?
Because if you don't believe in the Bible, God will damn it to hell when you die.
Wow, Maybelle. Where'd you hear that?
That's right, huh, Jess? God damns it to hell if you don't believe in the Bible.
I think so.
Well, I don't think so. I seriously do not think God goes around damning people to hell. He's too busy running all this.
Coming.
Get my drill out of the greenhouse.
You haven't managed to kill those things yet?
Not funny.
Ever thought of putting him in the sun?
Jess. Jess, where are my keys?
What?
My keys. You never gave them back to me. Think.
I put the drill down right here. They gotta
damn
be.
Damn it, Jess. The keys to the store on there, the register, all of it. They have to replace those locks at $600-$700 out of my paycheck.
They gotta be right around here.
If I don't have those keys to open up this weekend,
I'll find them, Dad. I promise.
Why don't you just draw me some damn money to pay for it? How about that? Make yourself useful and draw me some damn money.
I said I'll find them.
I didn't know. You look awful. What's the matter?
I lost the keys when my dad goes to work. And now he has to get new keys made and locks.
Maybelle?
And...
Please don't let anyone get mad at me.
What?
Hey, Jess, I know where your dad's keys are.
You do?
You know, the bells we talked about making. Well, it was meant to be a surprise. All that clanking metal and junk. And Maybelle wanted to help.
And you let her?
Maybelle, why did you tell me you found the keys on the ground?
They were on the ground.
Yeah, on the ground in the greenhouse. What's the matter with you? Dad's ready to kill me.
I was waiting for the right time.
So you know where the keys are?
See you later.
Tell Mom I'll be home in a little bit.
Are you gonna tell Dad it was me?
Don't worry. It's my job to get Dad's keys back. See you later.
Whoa. Look how high it got. Come on, let's go.
Get your hat out of the clouds, boy. Draw me some money. Make yourself useful and draw me some money.
What are you going on about?
This isn't one of your cartoons. This is serious.
Yes.
I mean, what's so great about being serious all the time anyway? Tell me that.
What if the Dark Master gets the keys first?
I'm not scared of any Dark Master, and those are my dad's keys. Leslie, get behind me.
Jess, turn around. There's more.
Here, take this.
P.T. Where are the keys? Here. Open this.
Where are Terabithium warriors when you need them?
I don't know.
Great, now there's three of us. Wow.
Now we're even.
Thank you.
Jess, I called you 3 times.
It's your girlfriend.
She's not my girlfriend. Hey.
Hello, Jess.
Wait, who is this?
I know it's a Saturday, but it's your teacher, Miss Edmonds.
I was planning on taking my nephews into the city to the museum, and my sister changed her plans last minute, so I had a thought.
Hey, Mom.
Is it the baby?
No, she's fine. Mabel's got her. Teacher wants me to go on a field trip today.
Mm-hmm.
Is that okay? Miss Edmonds? Yeah, I can go.
All set?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yes, ma'am.
Forget something?
No, I'm good. I wanna feel, I wanna really know. I gotta be who I am now to tell you that you'll forever shine.
Do you like it?
Yeah.
It's Bruegel. It's one of my favorites. I wonder if he started on notebooks like you. I know Da Vinci did.
It's amazing how much detail is put into it.
You've been to a museum before, right?
No, it's my first time.
Really?
Yep.
Well, then I'm honored. Such a nice day out. It's been raining so much this month, I was beginning to think it was like that Japanese myth where the sun goes into the cave and vows never to come out.
You know about everything.
Not by a long shot, but I do try to keep an open mind, and you'd be surprised what finds its way in there.
That's what Leslie Burke says. She told me to keep my mind wide open.
Leslie Burke is right. Mind like yours wide open, you could create a whole new world.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
Maybe we could do this again sometime.
Absolutely.
Hey, guys.
See, I told you.
Oh, my God, Jess.
Where in God's name have you been?
Where have you been?
Mom, I asked you. It wasn't like a...
They thought you were dead.
Brenda, hush.
Dad? What's going on?
Your friend Leslie's dead. She drowned in a creek this morning. Apparently she tried to swing across on a rope and it broke. They think she hit her head.
No, it's not that kind of rope. It couldn't break. It wouldn't have.
But it did. I'm sorry, son.
No, you're lying. She's not even dead. You're lying.
Jess!
Some breakfast?
I gotta do my chores first.
Your dad's doing everything today. You just sit down. Jess, your father and I thought we'd go over to the Burks today and pay our respects. Just the three of us.
Paying what?
Leslie, she never had much luck making friends at her old school. We were hoping that when we moved out here, she would. She said if it wasn't for you, Jess, you're the best friend she's ever had. I want to thank you for that.
You're welcome. Jess, next time, we should invite Leslie to go. She'd like that.
Hey, kid. Sorry about your friend.
Looks like it's the fastest kid in the class now, huh? It's a joke, dude. Are you nuts?
Jess Ahrens. Go wait for me out in the hall. Silent reading until I get back. Jess.
When my husband died, people kept telling me not to cry. People kept trying to help me to forget. But I didn't want to forget. Things that girl came up with. I don't get students like her too often. So I realize that if it's hard for me, how much harder it must be for you.
I was worried about you.
Well, don't be. I don't want you here.
I want to come with you.
This is our place. Go home. This is our place. I said go home!
What's the matter? What's the matter, baby? Jess, it's okay, son. It's okay.
It's all gone. It's like the Bible says, is she going to hell?
I don't know everything about God, but I do know he's not going to send that little girl to hell.
That I'm going to hell because it's all my fault.
Don't you think that even for a minute.
But it is. I didn't invite her to go to the museum with me. I didn't want to invite her. I wasn't there to go with her. It's my fault.
No, 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 no. It's not your fault. None of that makes it so. It's a terrible thing. It doesn't make any sense, but it's not your fault, Jess.
She's
she brought you something special when she came here, didn't she? That's what you hold on to. That's how you keep her alive.
Maybelle?
Look. I'm sorry I pushed you. That was stupid. And wrong. And I really miss you talking to me. In your hands
Sorry, I didn't see you.
Can I? Can I use the plumber by your house?
Yeah, of course. Anything you see, you just... You know, I meant to give you Prince Tarion, but I can't seem to give him up.
Leslie would have wanted you to have him.
Playing by ourselves.
Okay, but I know the most incredible place to play. You gotta promise you're not gonna tell anybody about it. Not Brenda, not Ellie, not even Joycey.
Tell Joycey a secret between you and me? She's nothing but a baby.
You're right, and she's not ready to be a princess yet. You'd have to train her and stuff.
Princess? Who gets to be the princess?
Step down. Watch your step. not peeking, are you? Step up. The rumor that the beautiful girl arriving today is the new future ruler of Terabithia.
Who her?
The Terabithians. They've been waiting.
Where? I don't see them.
It's an ancient forest, Maybelle, full of magical creatures and friendly giants, anything you can imagine. But you gotta look really hard. But keep your mind wide open. What do you think?
Can there be purple flowers?
Anything you want.
Wow. And a castle. A big one with towers and flags.
Of course.
Look, Jeff. It's beautiful. King? Are you the king, Jess?
Only if you're a princess.
Keep on believing. There's no question. When I close my eyes, I can see your face and the sun shining through on that special place. And you,
you were always gonna be my
queen. I was always gonna be your queen.
I was always gonna be your
queen. You were always gonna be my
queen. You know that we can always be anything. Remember now,
whatever may come, whenever you're lost, remember there'll always be a place for us. Castles rebuild and crumble to dust. Don't worry, there'll always be a place for us. For us, a place for.